Come and hear, all you who fear God. Let me tell you what he has done for me.
Today in John chapter 8, verse 18, I am the one who testifies for myself. My other witness is the Father who sent me.
Welcome back, everyone. Let us bow our hearts to the Lord for all his wonderful many blessings. Dear Jesus, thank you for today. Thank you for our wonderful many blessings today. Please be with the states of Ohio and Oklahoma, as well as the countries of Panama, Papua New Guinea, Paraguay, Peru, the Philippines, Poland, and Portugal. We are so thankful for all that you've given us, Lord. Help us be witnesses, not only to the wrongdoings of those who would try and harm us, but also to the blessings you give us. Help us be witnesses that can tell the tales of how you have given us new life and blessings beyond imagination. Help us be witness to those who are suffering. Help us to not only focus on our own pain, but on the pain of others, and to help give your blessings unto them. We look forward to the day of your return, Lord, for the salvation of Israel. In your precious and holy name, amen.
Hello, and thanks for joining us. This is Our Daily Bread Radio. Your host is Les Lamborn.
Did you know that God has left us in the world to witness to the world? In a criminal court case, witnesses provide vital information about a possible crime. Being a witness means telling the court the truth about what you know. Just as the criminal justice system relies heavily on witnesses, Jesus uses bold, faithful, and credible witnesses to spread his word and to build his church. Before Jesus ascended to his Father, he gave his disciples a final command to launch a worldwide witnessing campaign. The Holy Spirit would come upon them and give them supernatural power to be his witnesses throughout the world. Jesus called these early apostles to go into a world where people did not know about him and to give a truthful account of what they had seen, heard, and experienced. Since they had witnessed his perfect life, teaching, suffering, death, burial, and resurrection, they were to go out and give a truthful testimony about him. In taking the gospel to the ends of the world, we're called to testify to the truth about Jesus and how he's changed our lives. Romans chapter 10, verse 14 reads, "How shall they believe in him of whom they have not heard?" What are you doing to tell others? Acts chapter 1, verses 1 through 8 is the passage in which Christ promises the Holy Spirit. And I'll read from Acts chapter 1, verses 1 through 8. "The former account I made, O Theophilus, of all that Jesus both began to do and teach, until the day in which he was taken up, after he, through the Holy Spirit, had given commandments to the apostles whom he had chosen, to whom he also presented himself alive after his suffering by many infallible proofs, being seen by them during 40 days, and speaking of the things pertaining to the kingdom of God. And being assembled together with them, he commanded them not to depart from Jerusalem, but to wait for the promise of the Father, which he said, 'You have heard from me.' For John truly baptized with water, but you will be baptized with the Holy Spirit not many days from now. Therefore, when they had come together, they asked him, saying, 'Lord, will you at this time restore the kingdom to Israel?' He said to them, 'It is not for you to know times or seasons, which the Father has put in his own authority. But you shall receive power when the Holy Spirit has come upon you, and you shall be witnesses to me in Jerusalem, and in all Judea, and Samaria, and to the ends of the earth.'" Father, help us to do our part in telling the good news of Jesus Christ to those around us. Help us to be a good witness. For we ask in Jesus' name, amen. And as you think about today's meditation, remember, God has left us in the world to witness to the world. My name is Les Lamborn. Our Daily Bread is furnished by RBC Ministries.
I didn't walk beside him on the road to Galilee. I didn't hear him teach along the way. I didn't see